There are some bizarre things about the Galaxy Buds Pro and Buds2 Pro earbuds that I want to share with you. And right now I'm wearing one piece of these earbuds in each ear. And as you can see, one is clearly protruded more than the other, and that is a Galaxy Buds Pro. And if you have a closer look at the two, the 15% size reduction by Samsung is very visible. But I want you to pay close attention to both of these earbuds and see if you spot any differences. I'm sure you'll probably find at least one difference. But let's get back to this soon. The Galaxy Buds 2 Pro earbuds weigh about 6.5 grams each, and while the Galaxy Buds 2 Pro weigh just about 5.5 grams each, so we're already 2 grams lighter. The Galaxy Buds Pro case when empty weighs 46.5 grams, while the Galaxy Buds 2 Pro case when empty weighs 44.5 grams, so again, 2 grams lighter on the case as well. Now, you might say 2 grams lighter earbuds is nothing on my head, and 4 grams lighter with the case is definitely nothing much, and you're right about the case. But in the world of earbuds, those 2 grams can make a difference in your ear comfort and stability of the earbuds. And speaking of comfort, I wasn't really having high expectations for the Galaxy Buds Pro earbuds because of many negative comments some of you guys told me about them. And I must tell you that I was really surprised when I tried them on. And to be honest, at first, for like a day, I wasn't even wearing them correctly. So apparently with Galaxy Buds 2 Pro, this is how you're supposed to wear them. This is the windshield of Galaxy Buds 2 Pro, and they should be pointing up when you wear them. But the thing is that I was wearing the Galaxy Buds Pro also the same way, and this way they're sticking out a lot more, and the fit is not secure at all. So two things I changed was, first of all, the ear tips, which I changed to the large size, and then positioned them horizontally this way. And now they're way more inside, and they instantly feel more secure, and it's not that easy to dislodge them anymore. And as I told you in the Galaxy Buds 2 Pro review video, I also changed those ear tips. But at least if you have the Galaxy Buds 2 Pro, then in the Galaxy Wearable app, you can actually try a fit test, and then the app will tell you whether you have a good fit or not. But with Galaxy Buds Pro, there is no such thing in the app. So you just have to figure it out yourself, which isn't a big deal, because basically you should know better if they fit or not. And now's a good time to reveal the difference in that earlier shot that I showed you. As I just told you, I replaced the ear tips on both of these earbuds with the large size. But look, as you can see, not only is the large size of the Galaxy Buds Pro ear tip smaller than that of the Galaxy Buds 2 Pro, but also the Galaxy Buds Pro ear tips are more oval or egg-shaped, whereas the Galaxy Buds 2 Pro ear tips are more round in design and only slightly egg-shaped. Is that possibly one of the reasons many people don't like the fit of the Galaxy Buds Pro earbuds? Perhaps. What about the tip or the nozzle of earbuds? Again, the shape has changed from oval to a round design. The material seems to have changed too, but I can't say for sure. And in terms of touch controls, they both have very sensitive touch controls. And if I pull up both apps, you can see that with the Galaxy Buds Pro, you can block touches, which is nice to see. But you get far more advanced features in the Galaxy Buds 2 Pro app, which is absolutely great to see, except the touch and hold feature, which is a common one. And with both Buds Pro and Buds 2 Pro, you can also only use one earbud and still turn on the noise cancelling feature if you want to. And there's something bizarre about these two earbuds, which I believe is some kind of accidental feature that's actually quite fun to use. So in labs, there's the option to double tap the edge of the right earbud to turn up the volume, and the left earbud to turn down the volume. But for me, there's a lot of hit and miss involved, especially with the new Galaxy Buds 2 Pro. But with the Buds Pro, it's a little easier to target that area because they're large and more protruded out. But what's happening is that if I double tap my ear, not the earbud, but my ear, it also works. And I think that's for no other reason than the fact that they have, like I said before, very sensitive touch controls. And putting a slight pressure on the edge of my ear actually triggers the touches on the edge of the earbud. So now there's less hit and miss because I simply double tap the edge of my ear and not the earbuds. So it feels very futuristic.
All right, so I'm going for a run. Sorry for the camera shake, but there's a little breeze too, so it's a good opportunity to see if the Galaxy Buds Pro do a good job suppressing some of this breeze. It's not very strong. And I never thought I'd say this, but apparently the Galaxy Buds Pro don't fall out of my ears when I run. And I'll listen to the same thing with Galaxy Buds Pro, but it's not to hear. Alright, so I'm on an overpass right now, and the street is quite busy, and I'm wearing Galaxy Buds 2 Pro right now, so it would be nice to see if they actually suppress much of this background noise. All right, same place, this time wearing Galaxy Buds Pro, and the street is getting busier, so let's hope they suppress this background ambient noise.
So I never considered the Galaxy Buds Pro as a pair of exercise earbuds, and I still don't, and I actually never used them while working out for this very reason. But I still tried them when I wanted to go for a run. And actually what you just saw was a 15 minute jog, but I also tried running fast on a treadmill another time after that. And I actually tried both Buds2 Pro and Buds Pro. So Buds Pro got loose a couple times and Buds2 Pro also got loose a couple times, but Buds Pro faster than Buds2 Pro. Man, I'm getting confused with these Buds Pro and Buds2 Pro. And from my understanding, the more impactful your activity and the longer they take, the more likely that at the very least you need to adjust them a few times. Does that make sense? Hope it does. But I still don't recommend the Buds Pro if you have an active lifestyle, and with the Buds2 Pro with low or moderate activity, I don't even need to adjust them. But obviously the fit is personal and it might turn out to be a different story for you. So take what I say, but know in advance that you may or may not be happy with them, and it has nothing to do with the brand or the quality. About the mic test, despite the horrible wind noise that you heard, I actually really like the microphone quality on both Buds2 Pro and Buds Pro. And the Galaxy Buds2 Pro earbuds have three high signal to noise ratio microphones. Maybe if you're a biker, then that kind of quality where wind is easily heard is a no-no for you, but I think for most people they should be fine. And also I should remind you that you didn't hear a lot of wind noise in the Galaxy Buds protest simply because it was less noisy, not necessarily because they suppressed the noise better.
And now let's try another test with some background subway noise, and I'm wearing the Galaxy Buds Pro and now switching to Galaxy Buds 2 Pro doing the same test. I'm guessing they should sound pretty similar, but hopefully the Galaxy Buds 2 Pro's high signal to noise ratio microphones will do an even better job. So just let me know which one you think sounds better in this different setting.
The one thing that I didn't pay too much attention to is battery life, but I did notice that this one, including the case, the Galaxy Buds Pro, drains a little faster. And speaking of the case, what I like about both of these cases is that they can be charged wirelessly as well as with a USB-C cable. And you don't even need to have a wireless charger because you can just use your phone's reverse wireless charging if it has one. And I noticed that the case of Galaxy Buds Pro does not open and close as solidly as the case of the Galaxy Buds 2 Pro. I don't know if it's just my unit that's perhaps a little defective or what, but there's definitely less resistance when opening and closing this case. So in terms of audio quality, this is interesting. The Galaxy Buds Pro earbuds sound good. The separation of highs and lows is noticeable, but when I listen to the same source, same music, and I switch from Galaxy Buds Pro to Galaxy Buds 2 Pro, not only do they sound louder, but also the bass is stronger in a good way, meaning it doesn't ruin the mids and so on. The truth is that I didn't have high expectations for any of these earbuds sound balance, but now I get really excited every time I wear them, and I genuinely like what I hear. Now, I don't think I'm an audiophile, and I'm also not an expert in audio, but if I had to guess why they sound a little louder and better is because of the 24-bit audio perhaps, but at the same time, I'm a little skeptical of the true benefits of a 24-bit audio outside of a studio-like environment. Like I said before in the Galaxy Buds 2 Pro review video, besides your audio source, for example, a music streaming app needs to have these high-res audio tracks, but I didn't make these, and it could very well be the reason they sound great. The other thing that I think might have contributed to this is the fact that now the tweeter of the Galaxy Buds 2 Pro is 5.3 millimeters, which is smaller than the 6.5 millimeter tweeter of the Galaxy Buds Pro, which results in louder, higher frequencies reproduced. And by the way, both Galaxy Buds Pro and Buds 2 Pro have two-way speakers, meaning a woofer and a woofer for deep bass and a tweeter for high frequencies. And if they were three-way speakers, then they would have had a dedicated part to reproduce mid-range frequencies. I'll leave that to you guys who end up buying either of these earbuds to decide whether the mid-range frequencies sound great or not. So here's the deal with the ANC. It's the least impressive part about both of these earbuds, and I guess the painful part about any earbuds with active noise canceling is that if they don't have a snug fit, then the ANC feature is barely useful. But with these earbuds, even with a good fit, the ANC is still not good enough for me. But with the Galaxy Buds Pro, you can select between two different noise canceling levels, but with Buds 2 Pro, you won't get that kind of setting. So by default, I think it's the highest level. But does changing the intensity of the ANC on Buds Pro actually work? At best, it's marginal. And I'm sure some of you are wondering, what about ear canal pressure? And truth be told, I've never felt any pressure whatsoever with any of these two earbuds, with or without ANC, so thumbs up for that. But again, just like the fit, this might change from person to person. The ambient mode on the Galaxy Buds 2 Pro does a good job. It's definitely not the best ambient mode I've ever heard. And if you're wondering why I'm saying that, that's mainly because the sound doesn't come as natural. And of course, this is me perceiving the ambient sound like this. And for somebody else, it might sound great. Then there's Galaxy Buds Pro, and the ambient mode sounded almost exactly the same. But the biggest difference is that with Galaxy Buds Pro, you can actually adjust the level of ambient sound in the Galaxy Wearable app, which is a nice bonus. And in my test, it sometimes really does help hear your surroundings better, and it makes everything more amplified. In fact, the amplification goes up to 20 decibels. The downside of doing that is that it also amplifies the natural ambient hum around you that can be annoying. And also, there is no way to quickly adjust this on the earbuds themselves. So it's probably not something you're going to be using a lot, because it takes time to open the app and set the right volume. You probably set it to a certain level and you forget about it. Because I don't think if somebody approaches you while you're listening to something on your earbuds, you'd say, hold on, let me go to the app and increase the ambient sound volume so I can hear you better. And as far as multi-point connectivity is concerned, I've tried to connect them to a MacBook Pro and a Galaxy phone, and I can only be connected to either one at a time. So if I'm listening to something on my MacBook Pro and I want to make a call on my phone, I have to connect to the earbuds myself. And here's something I bet not everyone knows. Let's say you have a Galaxy Tab on an iPhone. We know that to truly take advantage of all the features of these earbuds, you need to have a Galaxy device. But did you know that in that scenario, that let's say you have a Galaxy tablet or phone at home and you also have an iPhone that's your daily driver perhaps, you can still use the features that you've set up on your Galaxy device. So you can use the volume controls by tapping the edge of your ear. You can also use the ANC or ambient mode and other media controls. Even if you don't have the Galaxy device with you, I think that's pretty amazing. What do you think? Did you know about this? This I figured out myself and I was really surprised. I think if you're looking for the best value for money, the Galaxy Buds Pro is a no-brainer. And in terms of the differences in the app, I think there are things that if Samsung wanted to, they could add to the Galaxy Buds Pro. Things like the touch control settings that we see in the Buds 2 Pro app, but things like Bluetooth 5.3 and a near future LE audio and a 24-bit audio and a smaller design might make the Galaxy Buds 2 Pro worth a try. But if you've never had any ANC headphones or earbuds and this is your first time and you want to experience the best active noise canceling, going for an over-ear pair of ANC headphones might be a better idea for you. So subscribe and stay tuned for the review video of these brand new ANC headphones. And once it's ready, I'll put the video here. But in the meantime, you might be interested in watching this video.